Jesus wants to speak, so I'm going to speak with Jesus. Come divine will, come speak in my speaking. Hi folks, and those of you who are following the videos know that I'm doing a lot of work on volume 25, kind of like digging a deep well into this particular volume. I'm getting a lot of food from it. So this is volume 25, February 27th, 1929. Since there is no sanctity, past, present and future, of which my divine will has not been the primary cause, informing all the species of sanctity which exist. It therefore holds within itself all the goods and effects of sanctity which is as issues, has issued. And so the soul who will live in my will by possessing its life with all its effects will see within herself altogether all the sanctities which have been issued. So if you've ever asked the question, how is the divine will the sanctity of sanctities, and how can I possess within myself all the other sanctities, how can the divine will be the crown and completion of all the other sanctities? Well, there it is. All the goods and effects of sanctity which you've seen through the centuries from Moses and Elijah and Elisha, etc., from Enoch, who was taken, from Noah, from all the saints of the Old Testament, and then to the prophets, the apostles, the Benedictines, the Franciscans, the Dominicans, Ignatius of Loyola, so the Jesuits, the Carmelites, all those sanctities have issued forth from the divine will. So the divine will has given those sanctities to those saints, but they have not been in possession of the divine will itself. She will be able to say, the others, I have done one part of sanctity, while I have done everything. So with the Franciscans, one part of sanctity. With the Jesuits, one part of sanctity. With every other sanctity in the history of humanity, there's been one part. But with the divine will, everything is now clumped together, as it were. I have enclosed everything within myself of all that each saint has done, because we're now living in the divine will. We are living in what the previous saints had simply done. They had done a form of something within that sanctity. They had had a good, an effect of that sanctity. We take possession. We can take possession of the fullness of the divine will. Therefore, the sanctity of the ancients, that of the prophets, that of the martyrs, will be seen in her. The sanctity of the penitents, the great sanctities as well as the small ones, will be seen in you. Okay, you. This is what you're striving to get a hold of. Not only this, but the whole creation will be seen portrayed in her. In fact, my divine will loses nothing by issuing its works. On the contrary, while it puts them out, it holds them within itself as primary bound. Therefore, for one who lives in it, there is nothing that my divine will has done or will do of which she will not have possession. Folks, elsewhere in Luisa's diaries, Jesus says that for the soul living in the divine will, every day is Christmas Day. Well, I say to you, Happy Christmas. Jesus is offering you the greatest of all gifts, and this is the greatness of what he's offering you in this day, in this era, now in the church. Praise Jesus. Fiat voluntas tua.